Today we're talking about the Cambridge Analytica scandal. One of the worst things to happen on Facebook since my mom sent me a friend request. Ah, yes, Cambridge Analytica. A company that sounds like someone just googled smart-sounding words and chose the second result, because perfunctory non sequitur was already taken. Alright, so I'm sure you've heard a thousand times what they did, but much like Batman's origin story, you're gonna have to endure it one more time, this time with my personal spin. Here's Forbes with more.
This academic made an app. It was a personality quiz that he posted on Facebook. Anyone could download it and answer questions about themselves. In the back end, that app was actually taking personal data about those people who downloaded the app, and also data on all those people's friends.
So next time you see a Facebook quiz asking what your social security number says about your personality, I recommend you keep scrolling. Alright, so that does sound like pretty damning evidence to the point where you would maybe consider closing your Facebook. But this leads to the point that makes me, and probably a lot of people who market things online, like me, laugh pretty hard. Because what was Cambridge Analytica trying to do? Well, enjoy this breaking news story from before the election in 2016.
They're trying to get to know you better than you know yourself. They are psychological profilers. And their aim, to persuade you to vote for Donald Trump with political ads that match your personality. Alexander Nix is the CEO behind the elite brains at Cambridge Analytica.
Yes, they were trying to use data to optimize ads, and it's pretty interesting how cavalier we were at the time. Again, remember this was before the election in 2016.
Using a survey placed on social media, they ask users to take a personality test. The answers group people under personality types. They then combine it with your voting history, what you buy, where you shop, and even what you watch on TV. With that, they say they can predict the personality of every single adult in the United States.
Alright, so elephant in the room, that story doesn't match up perfectly with the news story we heard earlier. Because getting the information from someone who took the quiz is very different from getting the information from the friends of everyone who took the quiz. In the same way that you can't say you're in a monogamous relationship while you sleep with all of his friends. So I want to get to a larger point here. Because while there are clearly some ethical problems, in the big picture, what we're really getting so worked up over is... make it stop! Oh wait, is that 12 issues of The Economist for $12? Focus, Stephen, they don't sponsor you! Yeah, all of Cambridge Analytica's innovative strategies for mind reading would be like me running into a boardroom and saying to the CEO, I had a breakthrough! If we sell more product, we'll make more money! Now, I have a unique perspective by which I can give you a look behind the curtain. Check out all the options from Facebook I have at my immediate disposal as a one-man operation who has done exactly zero independent data mining or independent research. First, we have our basic stuff, like location, age, and gender. This person's a 40-year-old man in Kentucky. Maybe we don't advertise to him our Roe vs. Wade episode. But that's just the tip of the information I have access to. Put on your tinfoil hats, everyone, because it starts to get weird. So, Facebook advertising breaks it down into four different levels. My favorite is more options because, well, I'm glad to see we put in all the effort to help people advertise to nail care. The rest of this might creep you out though, because I can target you based on your politics down to the degree of how radical you are, whether your anniversary is coming up. Hey, he's celebrating his anniversary next weekend. Maybe he wants to see how North Korea could destroy the entire world. Whether you live away from your family or are currently in a long-distance relationship. Heck, I can even target you based on whether you have a heavy mortgage on your house, what your multicultural affinities are, and what charities you donate money to. And sorry, but you didn't even have to take a quiz for that. I get all that info and you don't even get to figure out which Friends character you are. I'm a Chandler. Going back to Cambridge Analytica, turns out they weren't even good at what they did. The New York Times reported that they were best at talking and creating a great presentation, and their unique algorithms were pretty much worthless. They mostly got grandfathered into the campaign after the candidate they actually wanted, Ted Cruz, dropped out. Yeah, I can't imagine how much data they'd have to steal to make him seem like an electable candidate. So, just briefly, I want to go over what this scandal is and what it isn't, because it is being presented like it's the next Equifax hacking all over again, and that your proprietary information was stolen from you. But that's not exactly how it worked. It's more like someone took the information Facebook learned about you and was selling to people like me, and decided to cut out the middleman. A more appropriate example would be like you using Pirate Bay instead of paying $10 for a movie on iTunes. Now, when most people imagine the type of data that Cambridge Analytica was using, they're probably imagining maybe phone records or your arrest record, but in actuality, it was more like
credible connections. Liking curly fries gave clues about intelligence. Hello Kitty indicated political views. Collect dozens or hundreds of likes, plus other data, and you can build a rich analysis of the American electorate.
Yeah, most of the data they were using was coming from which groups you like, as well as what Hello Kitty paraphernalia you like. So they for sure have identified this guy's core voting demographics. Now, the major worry here is that this group that wasn't Facebook could collect this massive database of what brands people liked, what food people liked, and what party they belonged to. And the idea was that they could find strong traits linked to certain parties. The only problem? All the strong traits regarding politics and personality were so obvious that it wasn't really worth much, and it ended up mostly leading to a conclusion in an ad campaign that me and a friend might have been able to create over a few weekends if we had a budget and some coffee. Again, this is weird, but the data isn't exactly the scandal. It all exists in the company that's letting people use it to advertise to people matching demographics they want to appeal to. The problem is that one corporation probably violated Facebook's privacy settings by posing as an academic to get data instead of a corporation. This data acquisition doesn't end there either.
We can match them to cookies to serve people adverts through social media and digitally, or we can match these data to television set-top box viewing data so that we can understand where the audiences that we're interested in, what programs they're watching, and we can then serve their messages during those shows.
All right, again, this guy thinks he's a Bond villain. We'll serve them messages. When, let's be real, what you mean is you're going to buy a click ad or a sponsored post. So what is a cookie? Well, besides being the most addictive thing known to man, it's something in that can trace your internet browsing patterns. And right now, I can buy tracking data on as many people as I want, from friendly people over at Axiom, Experian, Quantium, and Ellipsen, TransUnion, and many more companies. It's not just the luck of the draw that the pop-up ads I see are geared towards The Economist. I haven't seen a Williams-Sonoma ad since I went online Christmas shopping for my mom. So this brings me to my conclusion. Liberals, conservatives, I've heard so many messages about how this is brainwashing and personality hacking, and it makes it sound like we're on the verge of becoming Soviet Russia. Now, this is an important issue, but at the end of the day, what these people are doing is trying to figure out what demographics to run click ads on. And if you're one of the people who likes and shares sponsored content on Facebook, just stop. Unless, of course, it's this video. Then I think you're totally in the right to share it with everyone. Also, congratulations on being a married 40-year-old with an anniversary coming up, who works in politics in Washington, D.C., is a moderate conservative, has a dog, and has paid off his house mortgage. You have a great life. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, I hope you enjoyed that last video, and the ad that ran before it, because you have no idea how much time and money probably went towards catering that ad specifically to you. Be sure to click on the subscribe button to get my regular feed. I do a post a few times a week. And of course, don't forget to like below. And as always, thank you for watching.